Hello and a happy one day. Wow, we're off to a good start. Happy Wednesday to everybody. Welcome to the Stream of Consciousness. I am Dichotomous Prime, aka Vince. I am a West Indian bi Canadian tabletop game creator. I do cultural consultation, sensitivity reading, and many different pieces of mechanical and narrative design in the tabletop space. But as you can probably tell from the title down below, today we are investigating the far reaches of the stars, as we will probably be continuing to do for a little while now, with No Man's Sky. I am super excited to get back into this whole thing. I did some playing off screen as well to kind of like get ourselves some more resources and stuff and unlock a few kind of basic things, but we are still in the midst of what technically counts as the tutorial, so only more adventures await today. Hello there, Sinziek and RPG Alchemist. Thank you very much for coming on through. I hope that both of you are having a lovely day and are generally taking care of yourselves with that good taking your food, taking your meds, hydrating, as I am just about to do right now. And generally, treating yourselves with the love and care that you absolutely deserve. So, as I was saying, oh, actually, you know what? Before I forget, I am going to drop something in chat right now that I care a great deal about. An excellent colleague and friend of mine, Alistair Guzman, who is an awesome tabletop designer. I was fortunate enough to be able to be on a panel with him a couple of months back, or with them, rather. And they have a number of really great, fascinating thoughts and feelings on various different aspects of design. They're currently in the midst of a Kickstarter at the moment to fund Tezuka's, I really hope that I pronounced this correctly, Tezuka Sentai, which is an excellent game that they are putting together for Zine Quest, and it's a combination of, if you are a fan of the Super Sentai, if you are a fan of Power Rangers, if you are a fan of Aztec mythology, then you will definitely want to be checking this out. Yeah, Alistair, as someone for whom the numbers don't work real well in my head, Alistair is someone who is excellent at explaining how to make numbers come to life and help them facilitate the types of stories that you want to tell in roleplay games. I always look forward to talking to them, and this is no exception. I'm sure that it's going to be super awesome. The art already looks amazing. And yeah, we are all about giving louder voices to awesome designers, particularly from marginalized backgrounds, particularly from places other than the Americas and Western Europe. So Alistair is just fantastic in all of those sorts of ways and deserves far more acclaim and attention than they currently get. So absolutely pop over there to the link that I just posted and support Alistair's work. Throw them some love, and just generally, yeah, awesome, awesome designer. And the great thing about it is if you continue to support folks like Alistair, they get to make more cool shit. And you will get to see that, as well as, you know, being able to make a living doing the thing that we love, which is making awesome games. Also, hello, CA Berlitz. Welcome back. I haven't seen you in a little while. I'm glad to see you come on back. I hope that everything is going well in your life, and a happy Wednesday to you, my friend. But yeah, on the topic of tabletop RPGs, as I mentioned on Monday, I started kind of digging a little bit more into Mutants and Masterminds, which is, for those of you who weren't there on Monday, a superhero RPG, one of kind of the foremost currently. And it's interesting because one, I guess the way that I could phrase this is, I haven't really looked at a game that is as what I will call arithmetically intense or crunchy since way back when I used to play Pathfinder. But in looking through the game, it kind of sparked some thoughts in my mind about how the term of like whether or not a game is crunchy or fluffy or any of that sort of stuff kind of fails to capture some of the more complex aspects of it. Because while I'm making a game that may not necessarily be like, it's certainly not going to be Pathfinder sorts of mathy, but you know, it's still pretty kind of narrative, leaning more on narrative than on like super numbers heavy stuff. A lot of the tools that I'm looking to make in that are not available, or at least I was not able to find in some of the kind of typical like more narrative heavy games. You know, the things like Powered by the Apocalypse, things like Forged in the Dark, and things like that. And it's interesting that like a lot of the time discourse will look at these things as being diametrically opposed to each other, or at least in opposition. Whereas ideally I would look at, you know, narrative gives meaning to the numbers help support the narrative. Because, you know, like one of the things which, if you're in any of the discords that I'm in, that I've gone off on a rant on numerous times of, is I love battle maps, for instance. I am absolutely gonna bring grid maps back. I will die on that hill. And, you know, kind of, I think, as a reaction to, unfortunately, some of the abundant toxicity in old wargaming circles. There is a lot of pushback against making games that, you know, feature combat as a central element or tactical aspects as a central element because maybe what those things represent, or kind of the baggage that those things hold, or the traditional idea of the types of people who like those things. But as awesome colleague and now creative director at freakin' Dimension 20, Orion Black has said on numerous occasions, violence is not necessarily a bad thing. Violence is not necessarily colonial or imperial, and I feel very much the same way. And so, kind of, while I don't begrudge anyone who wants to say, this doesn't fit what I'm going for the game that I'm making. I resist the urge to look at things like violence as inherently more than a tool. So it's like, if that tool doesn't fit your particular job that you're trying to do, absolutely, you can put that away. And it can absolutely be used to harmful ends, just like a hammer can. But you can also use things like violence, things like combat, things like tactics, to tell very interesting stories and just generally provide a skeleton, for gameplay in a way that may be more like either journaling games or more theater of mind heavy games might not be able to, or maybe not even that they can't do it, but that it may struggle for certain audiences. Like for instance, one thing that I feel very strongly about with respect to battle maps is that they are an accessibility tool. Numerous times, both I have ADHD, so I have short-term memory deficits, and it is very difficult without a visual representation for me to hold the spatial relations of more than a few things in my mind at once. So theater of mind combat has never really been a thing that I can do beyond something very simple. And I love me some complex boss fights as well. So to the end, I've had numerous players who have forms of, you know, either short-term memory deficits or spatial relations difficulties where, again, certain aspects of gameplay would not be possible without the use of tools like grid maps and things like that. So I think because of games like Dungeons and Dragons and Warhammer and things like that, that there's a very specific association of what grid maps and combat and tactical combat specifically are about. And I think that it maybe holds back things, or at least it will hold back people from considering certain possibilities for design tools to use that they might otherwise get a lot of use out of. And so likewise with the character creation in Mutants and Masterminds is real complicated. It's real complicated. But there are aspects to the splitting up of powers into certain aspects, whether it's like ranges, elements, intensity, all of that sort of thing, and kind of doing a build your own, that I find super, super useful. Even if the incarnation of that might not be as mathy or centered, or like have the entirety of gameplay centered around that as much as it is with Mutants and Masterminds, it's still like, you know, I'm scrapping it and kind of taking notes and being like, this is a really interesting perspective to have. So let's see. I also have to say that your particular takes are always such tasty food for thoughts. They always fuel my YouTube videos. Well, thank you very much, C.A. Berlitz. I am often afraid that with the amount that I talk, that people are waiting for me to stop. So I do my best to try and make my words count and to try and enrich the experiences of those who are reading or hearing them. So I'm happy to hear that my takes are a positive influence on your life. I ended up playing a Batman for the future Venom kind of guy. Yeah, it's the sheer flexibility for what you can create with respect to your character's power set is the central reason why I wanted to look at Mutants and Masterminds. It is not especially a strong game with respect to narrative tools or things like safety tools and things like that, but there is something of... I really like toolbox systems because just like, you know, give someone a bunch of Legos and facilitate like them building whatever monstrosity they want to build. Now, of course, there's a whole discussion to be had about like not every system can do everything. Pointing that out, Wizards of the Coast. But like, I do like the attempts of various different systems to go, okay, so if we're not telling you specifically what kinds of stories these tools are built for, and we want to hand them off to you for you to be able to take your agency and create whatever you want to create, how much direction do we give you? Because you could be a very experienced GM. You could be someone who is who has played before, but who is GMing for the first time. Or you could be like someone who this is your first TTRPG and you're like, what's a tabletop game? What are these dice? I thought they were only supposed to be six-sided, you know, that sort of thing. So trying to determine how much support and how much information and how much you can tell someone as opposed to assuming that it will be a given is very interesting. Just the whole dynamic of like facilitating people to then use something as a springboard and go off and do their own thing is always a very interesting topic to me, regardless of whether it's in gaming or in something else. So yeah, those are kind of my design thoughts that are kind of percolating in my head today. But yeah, and if you are enjoying those, it is always super, super welcome if y'all feel like clipping one of these that seem particularly interesting to you, or, you know, pumping up the stream on your various different social media, or bringing a friend by because like, hey, this Vince guy occasionally has a couple of good takes. All of those, if you're not in a position where you're able to follow or subscribe, all of the good word of mouth is super, super appreciated. So yeah, I'm glad that I am positively contributing to your experience in that. Without further ado, I believe that we are going to go over to here, and we're gonna say, oh, is it just not gonna acknowledge it until I actually go in here? Boom. And there's that, and then we will, oh, it's finally picking up on the capture, which means that I can transition this over to here. All right, excellent. So As we go through the star field that serves as our loading screen, I'll catch y'all up on what I was doing off stream. So, largely a lot of mining. I was trying to learn a lot of different new words because I found a space station and I found some other alien races. But the thing in No Man's Sky is that you don't understand what they're saying in the dialogue until you actually know what their languages and words are. So I went back down to the planet and I beat up the planet until it gave me all of its words. And so that's kind of where we are right now. So I am currently in said space station. So we're gonna take a look around, or at least I'll show y'all around, because I am reaching the point where I believe I am going to have to do the story thing, because I don't see myself being able to have enough money to buy stuff anytime soon. So here's my spaceship outfitting. And let's see, do I have anything to where I can upgrade stuff? And then, like, yeah, it's 1 million units or 10,000 nanites to be able to upgrade anything. So I can't do that. As you can see, I kind of modified my appearance a little bit. I was tempted to go with the Among Us style helmet, but I thought that was just slightly too meme-y. All right, what's going on here, buddy? Installable exosuit upgrades. All right, cool. Life support module, movement module. Can I not? So let's see if I. Now I think I'm going to have to. So this will take up my exosuit inventory. So that's interesting, because I'm gonna show y'all my inventory right now. It's like always full. Like always full. So right now I feel like the main thing I'm trying to get is more inventory slots. Beautiful. Now, do I only have one that I can get, or can I get more? Because that would be awesome. Or do I need to find another, like, inventory tech merchant person? Upgrade modules. All right, so we got movement. We got shields, underwater protection. Ooh, so we're gonna have some water protection. So radiation, toxic, that might help. Significant upgrade, module is flexible, and exact upgrade statistics are increases life support power. So, interesting. I am making it, and I have a lot of nanites right now, actually. So I am gonna go life support module. So let's. Don't wait. There was an information thing, and now it's gone. All right. Well, I messed that up. That's cool. So technology. I've got hazmat gauntlets, and what do we got? We got. Are none of these considered upgrades? Or does it just apply? Because everything else that I've gotten so far. Oh, wait, yeah, no, it just goes there. So I would go and I would install it here. Oxygen recycler, oxygen filter. Okay, awesome. So hopefully that means that I will have to spend less of my time looking for oxygen-rich things so that I don't die. Okay, so these little lizard guys are the Gek. They are basically the people whose language I've been mostly learning right now. They also communicate via pheromones, which is why this person is perfuming at me currently. Let's see here. Interesting. Okay. Installable exocraft. Okay. What? I don't have an exocraft. So I think an exocraft is different from my ship. So I Do I have anything that I can sell? Nope. Okay, cool. That's totally fine. So each of these different space stations have different stuff, and there's usually at least one, if not more, in each galaxy. So these are also upgrade modules for my ship. Let's see. Okay, so I don't want to do that quite yet. I need to find someone who will take my lootable stuff. Now, how expensive is this? Yeah, and it costs 2,065,000 units, which I do not currently have. But it will come with significantly more inventory space, which also means more space for me to upgrade stuff. So let me actually, let's talk with you. Okay. Now we're gonna see. So the usual, the rarity scheme in this kind of works the same way as it does in most RPGs. You know, goes from gray, green, blue, purple, I'm guessing, and I haven't gotten anything legendary yet. But we will. Yeah, and there's nothing that you want to buy from me. All right, cool, that's fine. I just need to, because I have stuff that I could sell, I think. Will you take this stuff? Because strange race, but their cargo is very valuable. Yep, that's cool. Sure, what have you got? Suspicious packet. All right, well, that's ooh, okay, wait. These are definitely things that I could sell. So where's my vortex cube? There we go. So I could. So we're gonna do all of that. And also the market changes because this is a multiplayer game, which is super interesting. Let's see, so salvage data, I don't wanna sell that because I need that so that I can upgrade my stuff. Let's see here. And then besides that, if there are people wandering around the lobby here, I can go up to them. And I can learn new words, and they can even help me practice. I can like practice my vocabulary words, which is kind of cool. So yeah, that's kind of been. Uh-oh. Okay, cool. Didn't take any fall damage. Awesome. So that's pretty cool. Oh, hey, buddy. You don't have eyes. No, wait, you do have eyes. They're just way all over to the side. Cool. Good story, bro. Issues forth a series of harsh barks. Sure. Are you gonna help me? Aggressive enthusiasm. Cool. Let's go. The. Doo-doo-doo. We'll go just Viking. Sure. Excellent. And I also have a Viking effigy. We are going to offer you a gift. So each of the different factions and races basically. Oh, he's so happy. You can increase your standing by offering them various different artifact gifts that you can find. And then also, we are going to practice our language skills. Yep, let's just do that. Cool, awesome. So does that mean that I. Oh, I got my standing increased twice. I thought I was gonna learn another word. All right, and I didn't realize I had another one. Excellent. So, one thing I do want to bring up about this game that is slightly troublesome. Hi, you have a triangle for a head. Cool story. It kind of falls into some same kind of troublesome tropes of that fantasy does. So, the Gek, who I was talking to before, are the merchant race. The Viking, these guys are the warrior race. There's the researcher robot race, who are these guys, who are also like a collective. And then there are also like, a couple of those basic sorts of things. So it does kind of like oversimplify sorts of things in the way that, like, if you follow me on Twitter, we talk a lot about sort of the idea of martial races or defining fantasy races on the basis of stereotypes that apply to various different ethnicities and peoples in real life. I have been noticing that it leans a little bit in that direction. Most of the dialogue is pretty kind of like very basic, just kind of talking to various different NPCs around the stations and stuff like that. The one thing that I have been noticing that I don't super dig is that, so let me see if I can find some folks. So back here, or at least in a couple of these other rooms, there are NPCs that you can hire to do various different things for you. Mechanics, researchers, warriors, that sort of thing. When you decide to like decline employing them, it's never like, no thank you or anything. There will be an internal monologue that's like, I don't trust this Viking, or I don't feel comfortable employing this Gek. And it's real kind of like, you could have just said no. You could have just said, like, I don't have the cash right now, which is exactly the reason why I didn't hire them, because I'm broke as fuck. But yeah, it's real kind of like it wasn't really needed. So it's always weird to me when people and developers kind of choose that as the default. The world of hats theory. Yeah, pretty much. It's like being a dick. Yeah, and just generally being like xenophobic in a universe that is quite literally with multiple, like teeming with various different races and people all over the place just kind of hanging out. And like, it's like, why? But why though? This is a game about exploration and discovery and excitement based around that. So it seems to contradict itself in that respect. Yeah, that's something that I was surprised at. I'm not a super huge fan of it, but you know. Missions? Okay, what do we got for missions, bud? Okay, so now these are. Because we're still kind of in the tutorial at the moment, I think I'm just gonna forego those. Because I don't really have a whole lot that I can do, and I'm not entirely sure if I can like even handle those yet. Okay, so my Starship inventory, I got launch fuel, we got a tritium hyper cluster. Sure, I don't know what that is. Quad servo. So I've also killed some whatchamahoosits, some robots called Sentinels, which we ran into in the last episode. And Sentinels don't like you. They don't like that you are taking stuff from any planet that you are on, and yep, they are not a fan. Also, I got a crap ton of salvage data, but I have now upgraded like all of the stuff that I can research, so I'm limited until I can get more stuff. How does the game deal with combat? So it's pretty basic so far, because it's mostly just like hostile fauna on various different planets. So there is my multi-tool, which has various different attachments. There's the mining beam for basic kind of harvesting. There's the terrain manipulator, which you can take big mineral deposits, you can literally reshape the terrain. And then one of the things that I put on there that's a modification is the bolt caster, which just basically it does what it says on the tin. I have projectile ammo, it's a gun. So it's basically third-person shooter sorts of things. Aside from the Sentinel robots, And the hostile fauna, there hasn't been anything super complex yet. That being said, I'm right at the beginning of the game, so we will see how that fares as we go on through. Let's see, is there anything that I can actually. Let's see, in exchange for usable star charts. Total value for each of those, so which one is my. You know what? Let's just do the actual mission first. Also, space. Also, I have hyperdrive. All right, let's rock. So I have this. Also, my pulse jump stuff will actually take up more fuel, but whoop, there we go. But we are gonna go down to the planet and we are gonna see what the heck is up down here. Oh, okay. This is weird and I'm here for it. Oh, those are much larger than I thought they were. Okay. What do we got here? Okay, ferrite dust and oxygen. All right. So, first and foremost, we're gonna set up shop. We got our portable refiner. And we're just gonna drop that. Oh, wait, what do I need for that? Craft metal plate. Do I not have oxygen either? Like, extra oxygen either? That sucks. All right. So let's see. Signal booster. Got that. All right. What's up, signal booster? So we're gonna see whether or not we have anything interesting around. Apparently not. Okay. Nothing found. Fair enough. Sometimes it be like that. Let's see. Save beacon, portable refiner. Wait. So I do have enough oxygen. Okay, I just need to craft some metal plating, apparently. Okay. Except I need ferrite dust. Okay, cool. Gonna beat the fuck out of the ground. Wait, no. I need to beat the fuck out of rocks. My bad. Get rid of that. Okay. Am I gonna actually find rocks here? Ooh. That actually comes in handy. Because that's everything that I need for a portable refiner. Ferrite dust and oxygen. Or at least for scrap metal. Perfect. Okay, cool. Portable refiner, need to make some metal plating. And then we got the portable refiner. Boop. And I don't have anything to refine right now, but that's okay. We're just setting up shop. Base computer, construction research unit. So, here is a bunch of the stuff that I have already researched. It's a bunch. So all of the basic habitable tech, signal booster, wiring, solar panels, which I also gathered a whole bunch of gold in case I need to make those. Hazard protection unit, all of these stuff recharges my shit. And I've been researching metal structures because wood structures are boring and flammable. And then it's pretty much, I have so much salvage data that I'm just gonna go through and research all of the things. If I can, or at least until I run out of salvage data. Cause yeah, they have every permutation of polygon that you could ask for. And short metal wall, well, just what I need. All of my metal walls are far too long. Let's see here. Full full stream ahead. Hello there, Nine. Welcome on in. Lovely to see you in here, and I hope that you're having a lovely Wednesday. I am trying to figure out exactly what the shit... Is that a jump pad? That feels like a thing that could be a jump pad. What has that got in it? Pure ferrite. Okay. That could be... I mean, I can refine that. That's not a huge deal, but... Can I hop on here? What happens if I stand in the laser? I'm sure nothing bad will happen. Nope. It's just a naturally forming laser. Good to know. Alright, cool. Alright, so we got all of that. That's totally fine. And I don't have any more research, salvage research stuff in order to use that. So we're gonna hold that there, and let's see what's up with this person's busted ass ship. All good, how's your evening? I am doing quite well, actually. I'm super enjoying this game so far. It's hitting all of the exploration buttons for me. What do we got? Sodium nitrate. Okay, I can use that. And I'm curious about where it takes us next. I'm gonna get rid of that so we can open this. What do we got? Corvax casing. Okay, so we got more stuff that I can trade. That's pretty awesome. And more damaged machinery. We're gonna get rid of this viscous fluid. What do we got in here? More starship launch fuel. That's never bad. Let's see. Go to my starship inventory. Can I quick transfer that to the starship? More sugar. Dihydrogen jelly. Might need that later. Corvax casing can go to the ship as well. And then I just got bullets. Good old-fashioned bullets. And then my save beacon. Cool. And this is another signal beacon. Bio input sensor. Okay, yeah, I got enough chromatic metal and I got enough sodium. Cool. So you said, there is only the static of a broken communicator. Extract records. Papers, please. Whatever message was once here has been scrambled beyond recovery. All I extract is the pilot's name, Artemis. Whoever they were, they are long gone. The only other uncorrupted data is a set of plans, an upgrade for my mining beam. I like that. Carbon nanotubes, hermetic seal, and a wiring loom. Okay. So craft carbon nanotubes. Can do. That's pretty simple. Just need carbon. I need to pick up more carbon from somewhere, though. Let's see. Ferrite, dust, and oxygen. Let's see. Dihydrogen. I'm pretty sure that I can refine something into carbon, but we're gonna take a look around, and we're gonna see if we can just kind of find it in the environment. Yeah, I've got lots of oxygen. It's fine. Oh, are these... Nope, more cave marrow. Oh, by the way, also, the caves in this game have bones, apparently. Wait a minute, I have an actual gun. What am I... Oh, wait, no, it's actually... more effective if I do that. Okay. What's going on in here? Cobalt and copper. That's not bad. Now, cobalt would probably be more useful if I can refine it into... I think it's ionized cobalt? But, you know, it's the first time that I've encountered just kind of like very common stuff that has it. Alright, cool. We'll keep that in mind. All right. We got, yeah, all of that is cave marrow. Scanner's almost, what the fuck is that? Interesting. Let's see, fauna, huh? First recorded in the dust bowls of planet New Hanisei. Predator move slowly and deliberately, preserving their energy for the hunt. They pursue their prey in short, intense sprints. Their adaptive sensory system temporarily shuts down their olfactory nerves as they snout through faecium deposits in search of undigested morsels. Extremely heterozygous. Okay. Interesting. I don't know if it's gonna try and kill me. I would prefer if it did not, but you know, we'll find out. Also oxygen? Nope, carbon. Cool. Now, how much carbon did I get from that? I have condensed carbon, which apparently is not good enough to make carbon nanotubes. Carbon times six. Advanced mining laser required. Oxygen. So the big bulby ones are oxygen, the flatter ones are carbon. Interesting. Got more ferrite dust. One carbon. All right, cool. I need a more efficient, like, source of carbon. Unfortunately, it looks like we are in Bob's weird ass rock emporium, where we got plenty of that, but not a whole lot else. Come on, scanner, give me something good. If I only get some ridiculously small amount, I might just like unrefine my condensed carbon down to regular carbon. Yeah, that's like one. Okay, cool. Yeah, no, we're not futzing around with that. All right, where's my ship? Where's my ship? Oh, cool, we got vents. That's kind of cool. Oh. What kind of mineral is this? Also, you get one thing that I completely omitted in the process of wanting to get more money is that when you get to a planet, you should scan the absolute shit out of everything that you see, because each thing that you scan rewards you with credits. So I have been trying to be better about that. Cave bones. Yeah, no, this cave has bones, Nine. This cave has bones. Let's see here. So let's. Because, yeah, I have condensed carbon, which is apparently fine. There's gotta be something else that I can turn. Let's see. So ferrite dust gets turned into that. Chromatic metal. I only have 8 units of. Pyrite gets turned into pyrite dust. What else we got? We got to hydrogen, silver. Nope. Well, here, I gotta put fuel in you first, so. Let's see here. Yeah, we're just gonna. So, I don't need that much refined. I don't need nearly that much refined, in fact. I just need like maybe 30 seconds worth of something. Also, I wish that I could. Can I just hold this and have it scroll? Because that would be awesome. Because I can also like re-refine it and it's fine. But like, also, I can just kind of go and do something else. Wow, the most basic crafting thing in the game, and I don't have the stuff for it. That's really funny. Let's see. Do. Antimatter. I can make antimatter housing, but I can't make carbon nanotubes. That's really funny. So yeah, more oxygen. Anything over here? Can I, like, rip stuff off your ship? Ooh, I can actually look at the ship. Oh, you have a bunch of stuff that's, like, damaged. Can I just, like, take your stuff? I would love to just take your stuff. Can I hull fracture, compare? Interesting. Compare starship inventories. Okay, so it has a much larger inventory than mine does. I would just need to, like, well, here, why don't I just add it to my collection? Cool. I now have that busted ass ship, but if I need parts or I can just melt it down, then hey, sweet. Oxygen. Did I get anything else? Nope, just more oxygen. Okay, cool. Scanning everything to get some extra cash. Are those new specimens just a couple of coupons in disguise? Exactly. It's, once again, capitalism motivates the entirety of everything. Let's see. So, we got more carbon than I'm ever going to need. Now, can I make some freaking nanotubes? I do not. There we go. And so, I got, what else do I need for the advanced mining upgrade thing? Where's my technology? I need a hermetic seal. I don't know if I actually have that. It's not stuck on my busted ship now, is it? It's a B class. Okay, so it is better. It's just broken. Yeah, and I would need a whole bunch of stuff to repair all of this. That's really interesting. Corroded tanks, burnt out compressor, damaged gears. Can I... primary starship switched. Okay, cool. So now I have my normal inventory again. Okay. So let me... oh, wait, no. Install technology. So this also has just a pitifully small... so we're just going to move this over to... can I move it over to the ship? Nope, can't put it there either. Okay, cool. Good to know. Can I move this here? How about over here? Also no. Good to know. Mining beam may attract sentinel attention. Right. Okay, well, that would be... that would have been really helpful. Also, what can I not install in the inventory type? I still can't upgrade that. Okay, cool. So, terrain manipulator, bolt caster, 2 carbon nanotubes, and 50 chromatic metal. Okay, you know what? Let's try doing that, I suppose. I don't know if this is going to actually take up an inventory slot if I upgrade it. Interesting. One carbon nanotubes, one dihydrogen jelly. Yep, okay. Well, I can make that again pretty easily. So here, let's dismantle this. And then we're gonna go install technology. And then I also need wiring loom and I need a hermetic seal. Gather or refine condensed carbon. Okay, so I already have condensed carbon. That would be awesome. So I need 0 of 30. Okay, cool. I guess we're going to recondense our carbon that I just decondensed. Cool. All right, sure. All right, so... Okay, portable refiner, you're putting in work today. So, make it into... No, we're gonna take that out. And we're gonna put regular carbon back in. And we're gonna do this again. Come on, scroll. Come on, scroll faster. Is it gonna actually... There we go. Let her go. Oh, 30 seconds. Cool. That seems like enough. Okay, so what's the third component for this? And a wiring loom. So now I need to figure out what the heck I need for a wiring loom. Wiring loom is just a thing that I need to get from somewhere. Okay, can I just purchase that from someone, I guess? Cool. And condensed carbon. Gonna put that right there. And where is it? Where is it? Hermetic seal. Cool. Awesome, and now... prefabricated features. Okay, cool. That doesn't help me. Interesting. Purchase wiring loom from space station trade terminals. Okay, cool, so I can't make that. But this is literally all that was on this planet, huh? Yeah, no, this is literally all that was on this planet. Okay, interesting. Interesting choice. Back to the space station I go, I suppose. I need something with a better inventory, if I'm 100% honest. So, I think we are going to... I feel like I want to just have my terrain manipulator until I... Yep, there we go, that's fine. Cool. Until I have something with more room. Okay, and I've got everything that I could get from this planet, so... Cool, let's rock. The progress of upgrading a laser is more streamlined than upgrading a PC. Yeah, you are not incorrect. You are absolutely not incorrect. Okay. Oh, known contact. Okay, what's up? What's up, buddy? Oh! Interesting. You have a cape. Sure. You know what? I don't know who you are. I'm gonna regret that's a... Alright. This is either gonna be very good or very bad. Alright, well, let's find out. Sup, fuckers? It's your boy, not Artemis Entity. This reminds me of Independence Day. This is cool as fuck, though. Holy shit. It's a giant circuit board. Holy crap. Alright, Well, goddamn! Look at all this! This is super cool. Oh, wait, these are multiplayer people. Yep, yep. This is... Oh, wow. Okay, yep. I don't want to deal with any of you. Great. Is there actually, like, a reason that I'm here? Or did it just, like, just kind of plop me down here for no good goddamn reason? That's, you have face whiskers, and I can see your throat from the outside. Sure, what's up? Cool. Aw, well that's nice, thank you. Alright, what the fuck's going on up here? I wanna do my NPC thing and get out of here before I have to interact with Slapnut69. Alright, well, those are mission terminals. Who the fuck am I trying to even find up here? Oh, these are NPCs. Okay, cool. Nope, that's not right. You, iteration. Okay, cool. Cool. Oh, exocet upgrades. Okay, cool. Oh, interesting. Okay, cool. Personal refiner, extension of the exosuit, installing a small personal refiner, accessible directly from the... Okay, cool. And I've got a decent number of nanite clusters. Rocket boots, neurostimulator, let's see, rocket boots, efficient water jets, oxygen rerouter, shield lattice, aeration membrane. Okay, this is kind of cool. Simple translator. Okay. Nearby conversations before running the data through a contextual learning system to determine intended meaning. I wish I had more capacity in my actual suit. Because, yeah, I do not currently. So I have the hazmat gauntlet already. I was looking at personal refiner. What am I even doing? Superior translator. So... This is only 90 nanites. Cool. And I need yet another wiring loom to actually construction research station. What the fuck is this? Starship research. Hey, buddy. Cool. You speak in Creed lyrics. That's good to know. Let's see. Teleport receiver. So I feel like one thing I'm not a super huge fan of is that upgrades take up additional, like, inventory slots. I don't know how I feel about that, because it really kind of bottlenecks a whole lot of the game. But who knows? Again, I'm still in the early stages, so I'm not entirely sure. Ship-mounted teleportation device. Standard starship communication, transport of matter as well as data. Okay, cool. So that'll probably take me back to wherever my base is. That makes sense. So. Let's see. Exocraft upgrades. Don't need them. Multi-tool research. Okay, cool. Hit me up. Yeah, cool. Let's see, so I've already got the advanced mining laser. Optical drill, okay. I would still need to actually... I just need a merchant. I don't actually need the research right now. But I'm not really using nanites for a whole lot, so do I want to actually do that? Let's see. Yeah, I already got my... This is all my standard stuff. I'm just gonna dump ferrite dust. I can get plenty more no matter where I am, literally. So I need to... Let's see. So these guys are all research. Does the construction research station have... Ooh, okay. Now we're starting to get into the more ambitious stuff. So all of this stuff is stuff that I have researched already. Message module, galactic trade terminal. Oh, okay. All right, that would actually come in handy. I really wish that I didn't spend my salvage data already, but we live and learn. Okay. So this is all research. Is there a trade terminal somewhere in here? Because that would be a very good thing to know. Let's see. What do you do? As its power starts to melt your very being. Huh. And you haven't? Cool. Cool. Awesome. Gimme shit. Now that I lied to you. I reached out, only the tip of my finger grazed the gateway. The next moment I awoke up aboard the anomaly, I was transformed. Ancient monolith, though it shares aspects of their network. Use it as you wish. Nod with respect. Excellent. I don't even. Yeah, sure. Cool. Cool story, bro. Good to know. That's not ominous. Let's see. Speak to the station inhabitants. Okay, I mean, I'm a speaking to them. They're all kind of weird, though they seem friendly enough. So, you know, I'm not gonna be rude or anything. I do like your home is very nice. It looks like a circuit board. That's interesting. This person looks like a Gek, but does not have, but it has the head of one, but the body of not. It's weird. You know what? Sure. 10 units. Whatever. That's cool. What's up? Sure. I'ma smell you. Why did you lie? Oh, yeah. Interesting. Well, I've killed several. If you want to. All right, fine, whatever. If you would like sentinel bits that I have harvested off of them, I got you covered, my guy. That's totally fine. Genetic modification? Possibly. It hasn't been discussed as a thing in this game, but hey, sci-fi, anything is possible, right? The aesthetic here is fucking dope. I'm in a Daft Punk music video. This is sick. Oh, this looks like, detect the items I carry. Okay, cool. I mean, I wanted to trade with you, but the thing is not letting me. I'm a trying to engage in capitalism, my dude, but. Oh, hello, Coral Brain. I remember you from Subnautica. Gold nuggets. Transmit milestone data. Yeah, sure. What's up? What do I have? Ooh, I got a fuck ton of nanites. It's all good. What upgrades can I have? Upgrades are always good. Life support module. And I don't have anything to sell right now. Okay. I need, like, oh, shit. Nope. Floaty person. Bad. Can't loot anything. That's cool. So it's not given me an objective anywhere. Or if it is, I'm missing it. Probably because there's a crap ton of stuff just like on my screen. All right, let's go up here. Are you especially important? Person with a plus on your head? What's up, buddy? Home is pleasant, yes? Yeah, it's cool. Sure. Our anomaly wanders free, free like nada, to observe, to search. The sentinels, the Atlas, they do not care for this place. I feel their eyes hunting us. Yeah, sentinels are dicks. I remember that. The Korvax watches me. There is a patience and organic tilt to the way they hold their metal shell. Interesting. I spoke to Nada before. Awoke with the death of Korvax Prime. Could not understand why such things happen. Okay, so I think that these folks are all like a hive mind. Now I am divergent. The convergence do not see through my eyes. Nada is not alone anymore. Nada is with Polo friend. Now many other friends visit. Our convergence is small, but Nada is happy. Okay. Let's ask about Artemis. I do not know their number. Nada does not care to think about iterations as numbers. They were lost to us. Highly improbable. Our anomaly is lost to the Sentinels, but none should be lost to the anomaly. Okay. Sure. Who's Polo? Found my signal. Nada is safe. Now Nada finds other signals and makes others safe. Cool. Cool. With Polo friend. Where is Polo friend? Hey, buddy. Oh, I love your outfit. You got little goggles? He's like the lady from Last Jedi. The little one who runs the bar. Friends everywhere, if only you know where to look. Aw, that's a good mindset to have. Does not seem possible, but all things are possible, such as the universe. Valid. Always a signal, always a trace. Ask how. Our home will see to it. When you leave, you will not be where you were. Technically true? Technically true. Let's see. You'll be closer, or maybe not. Discovery is exciting. Yes. Before you leave, perhaps spend some time with other friends. We all help each other here. Speak to other travelers to earn nanites, learn new technology, blueprints, browse a huge array of base parts, speak to Nada about Artemis. Cool. Helios the Grand Analyst. Cool. Holy crap, there's a lot of startup to this game. Does NMS in general remind you of Subnautica? I wouldn't say that. There's already Subnautica kind of has a whole aliens are kind of a rarity in Subnautica, hence the whole deal even in the first or the second one of like, holy crap, there's actually alien stuff here. No Man's Sky is super ensconced in that. As well, Subnautica trades in a large way on the sense of isolation. Almost immediately, No Man's Sky kind of does away with that, both just from like all of the different alien races and all of the sorts of stuff going on with it. The color palette and design aesthetic does remind me of Subnautica, though interestingly enough, the aesthetic of the technology and everything in No Man's Sky reminds me of the choices of color in a lot of the ecology in Subnautica. A lot of the oranges, blues, aqua greens, and things like that. Because all of the technology in Subnautica is based around Altera, which is your local kind of faceless, soulless corporate company. So it's all like, you know, Apple product, white with black stripes and things like that, unless you change it. So I think that that's kind of interesting. I think the two maybe have something in common, but maybe not necessarily. Helios, what's up? Young one, you who still roam the boundaries of the universe, how I envy you. My time out in reality has long passed, but I miss it greatly. Sure. Give data for planets. I mean, that's a fair number of nanites. I'll take that. New technology blueprints. I thought I already did. And I got another milestone. All right. Oh God. Met 10 aliens. Cool. Hey, it's me. I'm back again. Oh, oops. All right, so I already got the advanced mining laser. What do I want to pick up next? So I've already got the simple translator. And let's see. I've been on a few toxic planets. I don't want to be on a bunch of toxic planets anymore. Base capacity of the hazard protection system, allowing the user to spend longer in hazardous environments without recharging their exosuit. I feel like I've gotten a couple of upgrades for my life support system. So I think what we might do is just overall upgrade the other stuff. Requires fuel is limited to refining one substance at a time. That's totally fine. Is there anything that. Oh, a bunch of this stuff I actually don't even. I haven't discovered components for yet. That's interesting. Hydraulic wiring, don't have that. Chromatic metal. Okay, that I would probably be able to make. Quantum computer, don't have that. Shield lattice. And then all of this stuff is just various different environments. Sure, you know what? I've got some nanites to spare. Browse a huge array of base parts. Look at that. I'm a browsing. I've browsed. Tell me what. Oh! They just give me a whole bunch of stuff and speak to Nadab about Artemis. I thought I already did that, but. Sure. Let's rock. Hey, I'm back. I've harassed all of your friends. Nadam and Polo drift between worlds and worlds. There are many. Have you seen them, traveler friend? What should I do? Let's see. Free to make their own path. Find Artemis entity. Explore with others. Travel to great sites. Can do. Others will aid you also, even though you seek the Crimson Lyre. What? Interesting. False entity. Korvax worship, but Nadan knows better. Nadan knows where it dwells. Nadal chooses to disregard it. Okay. Wishes you to be safe. Help with exploration. Mark your map with a great wonder, but take your time with your journey, find your pattern, speak to others on this station. They have things to offer you also. Okay. You're always welcome here. Aw, well, that's nice. Community research. Complete Nexus missions. Good to know. All right. So, here. Folks, what I am going to do is I'm going to pop us over to BRB and take a quick bio break. And when I get back, I will answer your question there, Nine, and we will continue on our happy little adventure. So, I'm going to mute myself real quick, and we'll see y'all in just a few minutes. right. So getting into Nine's question here. That's actually a very good point about the color palette. Thank you. When you say No Man's Sky quickly goes away from the isolation, do you mean it's not interested in tackling it, or says like location is not possible in such a vast and populated place? I think it's more just, well, here, let me pop over here just as an example. Pretty much almost immediately when you first kind of get off of your initial planet, you start communicating with people almost right off the bat. There are knowledge stones that teach you language. There's a space station pretty much directly off planet, no matter which tutorial planet you start on. And you are aware that there is a company and an economy because you can see that different things are worth certain amounts of money. The game immediately kind of buffets you with a lot of these signals that say, this is a community, this is a developed sort of space, to where you can absolutely like just explore on your own and excavate and build your own base and just kind of go out into the wild blue yonder and figure everything else on your own. But the language in which the game speaks is a language that speaks of economy and communication and interaction with a number of different peoples and races all over the place. Now, that's not necessarily a bad thing, but it's just, you know, it is a particular choice that the game decides to make in terms of emphasis. So yeah, it kind of, Subnautica is very much in the language of resource management in an immediate sense. It is, am I going to have enough food and water and other resources to be able to not die in the next 15 minutes to a half hour? And so basically, that's the language that Subnautica speaks in. There isn't really commerce, and in fact, a large part of Subnautica's ethos is almost placed in opposition to a large economic entity in Altera and in Transgov's as a whole. So yeah, the two start in a similar place but quickly diverge. I hope that makes sense. I don't see create exotic items from Quicksilver. Chitinous cage. What is any of this? Oh, these are just kind of like little. These are aesthetic sorts of stuff. Okay, cool. Cool. I don't need any of that, but cool. Good to know that that's there. All right, let's see if there are. Your explanations are mesmerizing, actually. Well, thank you very much. I do my best to try and communicate as clearly as I can. Okay, Cronus, can I buy your shit yet? No, apparently not. Yeah, I had stuff to sell you, but you had to talk shit, and your menu wouldn't let me, so there you go. Appearance modifier, I'm good. What's going on over here? Sure, what's up? I'm just staying here for a little while. Polo and Nada are very kind to all their friends. Aw, that's kind of nice. Towards the being at their side, their golden eyes contemplative. If it wasn't for Hesperus, I'd probably still be alone out there, drifting from world to world. Oh my god, are these two boyfriends? I'm about this. All their talk of friendship, they all seem to want something. Okay, and the optimism went out the window. Okay, cool. Pleasure meeting you. Say hello if you pass through again. We'll be right here more than likely. All right, cool. Hopefully you will be less racist when I come back. You are an owl man. May I ask you how many licks get to the center of a Tootsie Pop? I mean, I'm a wanderer right now because I don't know shit. Even afterwards, sudden movement from the other life form, Hesperus clears their throat. I believe we tread parallel paths, you and I, and yet, quite impossibly, we have met. Let us not make this our only encounter. Cool. Let's see. Okay. So these are all merchants. I don't know. So all of your stuff is upgrades. So, and all of the stuff that you can upgrade is stuff that I would have to install. But I don't think that we have just regular old merchants in here. At least not that I can tell. So I might have to just, like, find someone who can sell me a goddamn wiring loom. Search for clues about Artemis among the stars. Okay, so I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back to the space station. And we are. Oh, right, I'm out of sprint juice. I also need to buy more sprint juice. We're gonna go back to the space station and see if I can buy some upgrades, or let's just even see, like, what kinds of other planets we can maybe look for around here. Because we have. So, this is the one that I just left from. So, I discovered that. Okay, what's up, dude? It said that it was a known contact. Why is it an unknown signal? Is there anyone out there? Something's wrong with. All right, cool. There's a moment's pause. The only sound I hear is the background hiss of cosmic radiation. You found me. There's so little light, I thought I'd never hear another soul again. How did you find my voice? Yep, that's the long and short of it. Felt the stranger about the abandoned starship wreck, how I found the communicator ID. But I think I'm safe. There are 16 of them. That's not good. Also, 16 is ominous for some reason. It feels very biblical. I'm not entirely sure what the situation is with that. Fear and confusion dance within the eyes of the stranger. After a few moments of silence, they turn to me imploring. You don't know who you are, do you? Nope. No clue. All right, that was ominous. Cool. That's a cool story. I am going to. Where's my base computer? Summon the space. I can summon it? That's kind of cool. Scan for trade outpost. Well, you know what? Let's just explore a little bit. So I've got the anomaly there. And I have the space station up here. So let's look at the galaxy map. So,
Navigational data received.
cool. And there's another system that it looks like it wants me to go to. I almost don't want to leave this one yet, though. Like, that's almost. It's kind of funny because it actually resembles the way that I used to DM when I DM Dungeons and Dragons is you give me all of this cool stuff to actually look at and I want to explore, but then you're just like, no, now you have to go this other place. And I'm like, but I'm not done looking at all this stuff. Like, look, there's at least two more planets in this solar system that I have not, like, select targeted system. So this is where I am right now. And yeah, we're just gonna get out of here. I said, get out of here. Get out of here. Okay, so there's a space station. There's the anomaly. And let's see, what else we got? Can I, like, set course for another planet? Other than this one. And have I gone here? I've gone to Igor Tau already. There's a bunch of these rings, and right, let's get out of the asteroid field and, like, take a look around. Oh, hello! Is this a place that I've gone already? Okay, so I have gone there. Alright, yeah, cactus flesh, copper, pyrite, not a whole lot. I want upgrades. That's what I want. Are you just a rocket in space that I'm, like, thinking is significant for no reason? You are! Look at that. Perfect. Beautiful. Your base is in another system. Teleport back instantly using your space station teleporter or construct a new base using the base computer. Okay, cool. And I mean, I've got an okay amount of credits. Hull construction, deep space exploration, drone technology. Ooh, I can disassemble that ship that I added to my collection. So I think that is what we're gonna do once I go to the space station. But I'm also gonna have to, I'm also going to have to get some more launch fuel pretty soon, because it looks like my fuel is at least below half now. Let's see. Read the words that you say string into meaningful sentences. Well, I appreciate that is all that I can really hope for, honestly. Okay, so is the ship breaking down salvage platform over here, or is it on the other side? Hey, buddy, what's up? Let's see. $500 tainted metal. Interesting. So all of this stuff is... I just need to pick up junk and give it to him. Like, he doesn't just sell junk, he buys junk. And then... let's see how many credits I get for breaking down the busted up ship. So I could claim scrap worth 385,000. Wow, having trouble thinking of stuff for a moment. Improved starship class, 10,000 nanites. Yeah, can't do that yet. Okay, cool. And I'm not able to switch what is my primary ship. And can't upgrade my inventory there. That's fine. Okay. So, I think what we're going to do is... because we could take a mission from the dude who is over here. Because there's one that's, like, super, super simple. Let's see. What's up, buddy? From the Merchants Guild, they don't want to trade with me. Fuck you, too. Cool. Good to know. And then you give out missions. Sure. Browse missions. Take a photo on a tropical world. Take a photo on a toxic world. Locate a missing person. Okay, so is there actually, like, just locate them somewhere? Okay. Lost one of their spawn. The youngest of their litter became jealous of the attention given to the firstborn and reacted by stealing the access codes to the client's starship. The client has tracking data from the ship and requests assistance in bringing their spawn back home. Cool. Excellent. So I need to... so we will leave. Okay. Locate the missing person and persuade them to come home. Alright. Now, that's gonna be real tough because I only know several, like, words in this language, so it's not super ideal. Is there someone who I can trade this navigation data to? Where's the cartographer? Because we got missions, we got Merchants Guild dude, we got cartographer. Cool. Exchange maps. So planetary chart. Can I sell navigation data? Cool. That wasn't a whole lot, but I mean, I got something for it. Now, my question is, do I have enough fuel to warp to another galaxy? Hey, another journey milestone. What was it? Moneymaker. Alright, cool. That's a very specific number for an objective. Alright, let's locate this person and see if I can fail hilariously to convince them in my broken Gek language. Alright, so where are you? You are... Come on, where? Where? Oh, oh. Mostly harmless. Okay, cool. Where are they? So, I already looked down there. Oh, you're on this planet. Bounty? Okay. Not cool. Yep, that's super cool. Now, where's my actual guns? Probably should have remembered how to actually fight before I went to go get some kind of bounty. That probably would have helped. The hell? No, there's the space anomaly. Okay. Oh. Oh, there we go. Alright, cool. Look at that. Herox. I don't actually know what that is. Also, hey, I know how to fire guns now. Look at that. And just like that, extra 100,000 units. New Gek rank, client. Okay, cool. I mean, I did also learn a bunch of their words, so. Alright, let's locate this missing person. Oh, is this the creepy moon that I was on before? God damn it. I mean, they got some pretty precise coordinates. And landing sequence. Boom. Love it. And we're on another fart planet. That's cool. Hey bud, what's up?
Ha ha ha!
Found the missing life form safe and well in a shelter on a nearby planet. I should let the client know as soon as possible. Sure. Are you gonna get mad at me? You're gonna get mad at me. Cool. Well, cool. Well, do you have things that I can loot? I mean, it's damaged. You, sure. Dismantle that. I didn't, all right, I didn't get anything from that. That's cool. Well, that was anticlimactic, not gonna lie. Oh, hello there, Twisted. Thanks for coming in and hanging out. I enjoy your company on this easy and sleepy evening. I hope that your nap was restful. Let's see. What did I get out of this? Anything? Anything interesting at all? More nanites. Okay, cool. Okay, and your ship is just a damaged starship. That's cool. Okay, I need. Yeah, I would basically need more words to be able to communicate with them, I think. All right. I think I can launch. I feel like. Yeah, life support systems are low. That's cool. Let's get off the planet, and all right, that's gonna be my last launch. Wherever I touch down next, I gotta do something. All right, let's get into the atmosphere first before I boost. I feel like I might be in the midst of some rings, because like the whole multicolored space thing that's going on right now. I can't see shit. Oh, here we go. Here we go. We got stars. We got stars, folks. And that's the space anomaly, I think. And then that, yeah. The big purple plus sign is the space anomaly. I also like how the scale of like how long it will take you to arrive changes depending on like the different levels of speed that you're approaching. And it just kind of it's a really clever little design choice that really brings forward the feeling of scale of just the size of the distances that you are traveling. Yeah, it's just kind of like you didn't actually really have to do a whole lot. You're just kind of changing the units that you're using to measure something, but the overall effect of it is really interesting. Or at least very effective. It's fairly straightforward. Just lurking while working? That's totally fine there, Ro. Thank you for coming on in and joining us. I appreciate you. All right. Very cool to have a discussion that's moved away from just accepting exploration as a neutral mechanic instead of focusing on the way exploration frames the life of the player in the environment. I accidentally took off. That's my mistake. I'm too invested in all y'all's thoughts. That's totally fine. I love talking to you guys. To all of y'all, rather. But yeah, I've had a lot of thoughts recently regarding exploration, and I'm not entirely sure if I've crystallized them enough into something to be able to like make a post or something about it. But it kind of started from my thoughts on Westerns in general, and how like you can't really like the Western genre is a product of the time that it came out of, which unfortunately involved a whole lot of oppression and racism and genocide and a bunch of other really terrible stuff. And there really isn't a way to divorce it from those things without erasing the people whom it hurt. And so my next kind of question going from that was like, okay, so then what is it about kind of an unknown and going out there and exploring things that's appealing to people? Because I think that's like the excitement of something new and unknown can also be a very kind of like, it's a very base kind of like, I'm excited, what's around the next corner? Because like, you know, we have stuff like, and this is my example of one that fails to like divorce itself from the harmful aspects of Westerns, but my example of that being Firefly, extra relevant because Joss Whedon is back in the news today for being an abusive asshole. Anyways, the whole thing of like, well, it's just a Western, but we made it about space instead. And then it's like, oh wait, it's actually like the good guys are actually like the Confederates, and like no one really picked up on that. And how, like, we were just fighting for our freedom becomes a lot, like, more sinister when you realize that if these people are the Confederates, what we're talking about, like, oh, what was your freedom to do? Oh, well, you know, states, we wanted to fight for states' rights. Oh, states' rights to do what? States' rights to do what? Oh, and then they just kind of, like, look away. So then it's like, is there a way to talk about the excitement of exploration and all of the feelings involved in that without it turning into a colonial sort of mindset? Because there's a lot of the idea, say, of the untouched wild and the pristine thing waiting out there for us to discover it, that's also based in anti-indigenous ideas. Like the idea of if you ever go a place and, quote, no one has ever been there, it's very rare to, like, there's, I think Antarctica is the literal only place on Earth where at some point there was straight up no one there. Like, even the Arctic have various different kind of indigenous bands and tribes and peoples. But basically, so is there a way to talk about specifically in sci-fi, because you can't do it on Earth, because indigenous people are freaking everywhere, and to pretend that they're not is frankly pretty shitty. So if we're talking about space and we're talking about like wilderness and things like that, the very fact that life on like, you know, on a sci-fi level like this is still hypothetical is like the possibility that there is, quote, what we might call untouched wild somewhere. But the thing is that our idea of what makes a civilization is also very, very colonial and very Western influenced. The idea of like, oh, it's cities, or oh, it's literacy, is like wrong on both counts. Both of those things, there are people who had like certain like complex culture and art and all of this sort of stuff, and like that were civilizations that didn't necessarily build cities, or they didn't like have physical written language, and there were like spoken word records and things like that. So there's a lot of deconstructing to be done about like where and what you would say about like, what's the drive that makes people excited to explore somewhere unknown? And is there something to be extricated from that that is not based in a very harmful, frequently bigoted, frequently racist sort of framework? And I don't have a good answer to that question, because it's a very complex question. But that's kind of where my mind goes when we're talking about sci-fi, specifically exploration and survival type games. Serving the finest kitchens and gardens across system one, producing prize-winning cuisine. Let's see. Crops on my world. The required paperwork has already been signed, apparently. I don't have an agricultural terminal when I come back. But friend, the contract is already signed. My arrival is inevitable. What? That's a threat. I don't... Is... My arrival is inevitable feels like a threat. It's just like, no, you don't understand. I'm a coming. Like... Exporter. What's up, buddy? Let's talk. Can I learn some more words? Okay. Dialect help, sure. Let's learn a word. Okay, so I've already got something trade related. Something friendship related symbol. Okay. The Gek word for help. Okay, that might come in handy. And now let's practice our vocabulary words. Practice language skills. Toil Gek, traders, helps. Okay, so you don't like that. I said this word to one of them and they were very upset. So I feel like they don't like the idea of like using cybernetic integration. So let's say traders. Yeah, recognizes a master trader. They generously share a little of their wealth. Okay. I'm not gonna say no. 600 credits, all right. And you are another traveler. Decrypted user data, life support gel, unstable plasma, sodium, wiring loom. It takes 50,000 credits to buy one of those? That sucks. Okay. All right. Is there anything here that's actually, like, essential? Ionized cobalt. Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, I feel like what I need to do is, like, save up more money for... Because there's the other multi-tool that was over on the other side somewhere that has a way bigger inventory. Because I can't really even upgrade anything because it doesn't... I don't have the slots for it on my default multi-tool. And then my inventory is too small on the radiant pillar here. So yeah, I need to figure out what to do about that. Let's see. So I've got 250,000 credits. I've got some stuff here. I think we're just gonna boost to another galaxy, is what we're gonna do. Luckily, I don't have to use up launch fuel off of the planet. Locate a long-distance transmitter. Holo terminus detected. Over here again? I really don't want to... This is boring. I don't want to do it again. Could I... Galaxy map. So... Yeah, that's cool. Can I... Where's this other waypoint? That's the current location. That's great. Can I change my... Okay. Let's see. So this is where I currently am. Indium drive required. Out of jump range. Out of jump range. Where's the next closest? Have I gone here already? So I'm guessing all of these are galaxies. They're not even planets, they're all galaxies. Oh, wow. This is incredible. All right, let's go here. Why not? Just the scale of this game continues to absolutely blow me away. This is a very clever way of disguising a loading screen. But I love it. Gotta do it these days. first contact. Well, we're gonna see, because it said that the Gek were already here. So, unknown planet. Let's rock. And I'm gonna need to get some more fuel for my pulse drive, because I'm down to about a quarter tank. We're gonna see what's going on down here, though. Copper, gold, and silver. Scaly planet. Ships, plural? Okay. I mean, I might just, like... Alright. I mean... Dude, I was just gonna land on this planet. You could've just left me alone. That's totally fine. Goodness. Well, let's find out what's going on down here. Evasion is not an option. I probably could have tried harder, to be 100% honest. I'll try that next time. Also, this is described as a scaly planet. I'm not entirely sure what that means. Oh. Nope. 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 That's not good. About... Nope, nope, okay. I need to find a place to land. There we go. So, this is interesting. And also, I'm gonna need to get some more launch fuel before I can leave again, so... This is new. This is interesting. Alright, let's set up shop. Got the... What are you? So we're all good for that. Nope, that's not what I wanted. Portal refiner, save beacon. We're in another galaxy now, so I should probably plop down a save beacon. Why not? Cool. That way, in case I die, I should be fine. And we have lots of carbon for that. Let me just remember what I actually need to do, what I need to make launch fuel with. Starship launch fuel, dihydrogen, and metal plating. Okay, that's not difficult at all. Well, I say it's not difficult, but then I don't actually know what the chemical composition of this planet is, so we're gonna find out. Carbon and fascium. And just straight up carbon, okay. I need to power up my life support, because it's down to like 20%. Boom, all right, cool. GOD site, use for crafting, trading. I feel like I need to plop down a couple more of my total value, 450,000 units. I really wish that, light metal alloy found throughout the galactic outer edge, interiors of trading shuttles to reduce weight. Okay, that seems like upgrade material to me. Dihydrogen jelly, construction research unit. Okay, let me... Is the construction research unit actually even really useful anymore? Because I don't know if because I think I've got like everything that I can upgrade on this. Because everything else I now like, aside from a couple of the things here, everything else I would get from traders now. So that's very interesting. How's my multi-tool looking? Mining beam's fine. Terrain manipulator's fine. Okay, cool. And then I just need to recharge that with carbon. All right, let's scan. Let's see what's up. Do I have the signal booster? I should plop down a signal booster. If I have a signal booster. Yep, I do. Okay, cool. All right, let's see what's around here. Okay. Locate new structures. Let's see what's up. Let's see. Let me actually take a look in chat. Let's see. Now you can get these lasers. Exactly. I mean, you gotta laze something. All right. So we got carbon. We got, what is this over here? Silver deposit. Okay. I don't know if I need a bunch of that or not. So overall, it doesn't look like. Oh, and for those of you who haven't seen the terrain manipulator yet, it's pretty sick. And I don't need all of this silicate powder, but. Is that all the silver? I got like one unit of silver for like 50 silicate powder off of that. But yeah, so that's what the terrain manipulator can do. Let's see, and let me just get rid of that because I don't need it. All right, what else haven't I scanned here? I mean, I've literally walked 50 feet from my ship, so the answer is probably a lot. What is this? Distress beacon. Okay, so that's another area of the planet, though. Because that was a whole ass planetary scan. Got sweet root. We got, looks like we got some more indigenous fauna. I don't know if these bigger ones, because sometimes the bigger ones and smaller ones are different, are different species, or at least different offshoots. That's a big old dihydrogen crystal. Because, yeah, it doesn't look. I'm not seeing any, like, language stones or anything, or knowledge stones. There's a gold deposit over there. Okay. There is not a whole ton of biodiversity around here, it looks like. Hexaberry? Interesting. Got condensed carbon. I'll take some more of that. Okay. You actually shielding the crystals? Apparently it was. Okay, cool. Good to know. Got sodium nitride crystals. Yeah, there's not a whole hell of a lot. But there is that distress signal. So, I'm going to have to put together some launch fuel. and then we'll go over and see what that's about. Zab the Fish. Hello there, Zab the Fish. Oh, and thank you for the raid. Holy crap, I was super, super involved in the game, and I didn't even see it. Hello there, everyone from Zab's stream. I am Dichotomous Prime. I am a West Indian bi Canadian tabletop game creator. I do cultural consultation, sensitivity reading, and a bunch of different mechanics and narrative design in the tabletop space. We're continuing our delving, I guess, into more of the exciting world or worlds, plural, of No Man's Sky. And it is real interesting so far. That is just floating. I will identify that. So it's just cobalt. All right, cool. It's like, I don't know if the lack of direction is by design or whether to go with it or resist the attempts of the game to push me in a certain direction. Because, like, there was a crash here. There was clearly a crash here. So does that mean that there's stuff on a crashed ship that I can loot? Because that'd be dandy. Yeah, we're gonna see whether or not that's the case. And scanner's not recharged yet. And basically, I'll take a look in here, and if there isn't anything of interest, then we'll just go right for that distress signal. It's real ominous and quiet out here, though. Except for these little burrowing dudes here. There really isn't, there's not a whole lot of biodiversity on this planet. At least not from what I can see. Because pretty much everything that I've scanned so far is kind of the long and short of it. Maybe there'll be more stuff in a different biome when I go over and check out that distress beacon over there. Now, as you can see, it's going to tell me that I'm going to arrive in a number of hours, so that is not a thing that I want to attempt to navigate towards on foot. I will, however, check out this wreck first, because there might be possibly nuclear material that I can use on this. And then I can always just summon my ship, so. Or we might discover a biological horror, which could be real interesting. Oh. That is a cargo pod. Okay. Oh, that's behind there. That's not even this. What is this? Log extraction complete. Let's read the log. Life goes on day after day, delivering after I hope to go home soon. Oh, well, this is depressing space capitalism. To do the Death Stranding challenge in this game. What is that? Oh, wait, someone just... No way. Navigating the entirety of the surface of a planet on foot? I couldn't... Yeah, that's not for me. Also, hello, Lady Zephira. Absolutely, your lurking is noted and valid and appreciated, as always. I hope that you are having a lovely evening, and thank you for dropping by the stream. Okay, well, that's not good. Fighting each other. The Sentinel ships are engaging each other. That's... Alright, we got this 16 shit again. That's, again, ominous. Alright. So, let's take a look inside the parts of this wreck that I can reach first. Because usually there's a couple of these doors, and I'm probably gonna end up taking some radiation damage, because that's usually what happens. And this is nothing. Okay, these boxes are useless. Master circuit, magnetized, yeah, I've got that. Cool, and there's the radiation damage. It's all good, you just need to wait for it to get over itself, and we're good. Small price to pay for 50,000 units. And we'll have another one over here, I think. Is there anything else under here? Doesn't look like it. Okay. Oh, there's another cargo pod under there. All right. We'll take a look at that in a second. Yeah, that's fine. Just give me my shit. Oh, Starship launch fuel. Okay, cool. Yep, yep. I would like to get away from the source of the radiation, please. Thank you. Subterranean relic? Alright, well, this suddenly got a lot more interesting. Cargo pod, 89 units. Cool. This is... navigation data required. Oh, but I sold all my navigation data. Oh, that's underground. Interesting. Well, we got something that can do something about that. Come here. Tell me your secrets. Well, let me just walk through the ground away from this. Well, when you don't have a door, all you gotta do is make one. Yeah, and portable refiner, that's just all my shit that's over there. How is there a bunch of stuff I straight up didn't even notice? Alright. And it's another... Oh, this sank into the ground! Oh, that's... I don't know how I didn't notice that. So, is there a huge, like, network that's the interior of the ship if I dig it out? Okay. Okay. We'll see. We're gonna see in a moment. Now, what? Okay, you, sir, you're upset. I don't understand why you're upset, but, you know, you can just stay over there. I feel like I'm not gonna have enough magnetized ferrite pretty soon to, like, fix all the busted machinery. But, you know, if I can get some more resources out of this, then that would be perfect. Is it facing down? It's not. Okay. So, is it facing up then? Where's the anus? Where's the optical thing? Yeah, there's the radiation. Excuse me, what? What was in there? So there are levels. Radiation. There's levels to this shit, apparently. Okay, great. So, So did I just, like, waste that for no reason? Because I didn't get anything from it. Alright, cool, whatever, that's fine. Now, I'm curious about this. I want to see if there's an entrance to this. I'm going to have to repair my terrain manipulator, though. If I'm going to put it through its paces like this. Now. It continues to go down. That is very interesting. Now, is there something in the ship? Because my scan isn't revealing anything. That's my next question. Because, yeah, we got another cargo pod. Is it going to continue to show me the cargo pod even after I've looted it? It looks like the answer is yes. Okay. Well, let's see. Let's see. Okay. Nope, that's not what I wanted to do. Okay. Nope, not what I wanted. Okay. All right. This is getting cool. I'm super... meddling with things that man was not meant to meddle with? Fuck yeah! Alright. Okay. Let's see. We're trying not to get cancer. Exactly. Listen, sometimes cancer is the price of exploration. Let's see here. Alright. So, we have our thing here. So I need to dig around it and find wherever the control panel is. I feel, you know what? I feel super, super excited with the fact that, like, just the logic of, like, a bunch of other games would just be like, no, the ship just ends when it hits the ground. It's a set piece. But, like, they made the decision to make it so that this ship continues to have, a ship that is under the ground that you can dig out. And that is super, super cool. I'm about to eat a bunch of rads. Unstable gel? Okay, cool. Yeah, let me just... Yep, I'm aware. Yep, let me just, please recharge this. Cool. Yep, that's cool. All right, let me just walk away and let the radiation get its temper all figured out. Because apparently, much like all of us, really the radioactive material just needed like some alone time. Crafted from cactus flesh. Both energy rich and dangerous to touch. All right, good to know. Don't need that, that's garbage. Silicate powder. I mean, I can use that for the terrain manipulator, that's fine. Yeah, because I've already gotten unstable gel, which was apparently the loot that was in there. Let's see here. Oh, sorry about that, Nine is sick. Yeah, Nightbot is a little bit aggressive. Let me... is that... Nope, it's not gonna let it do that. Hey, Sin, if you're still around, it's slash permit, isn't it? For to let people actually post links? Exclamation point permit. Thank you very much. Yeah, I thought that I'd changed that setting, but apparently it is not. Boom. Awesome. Yeah, no, I thought I had that handled, but apparently we all learn things today. Such as if you give radiation a couple of minutes to just kind of cool down, it's all Gucci. It's totally fine. Alright. Let me just, like, push my luck one more time with this other cargo pod. Oop. That's a damaged panel. So, let's just tag this. Alright, and we got... hot ice? I mean, okay. I don't know what that is, but... hot ice, a paradoxical material, you don't say. Total value 320,000 units. Cool. I will take that, because that seems super useful. Alright, cool. So I think what we're gonna do is I'm gonna go back to the ship. We are going to pack up what I otherwise have looted here. We're gonna refuel the ship. And then we are going to check out that distress signal that is not too far away. Though the subterranean relic signal that I picked up is not too far either. Let's see here. Deposit. That's fine. Heptaploid wheat. Hexaplate bush. I don't know what a hexaplate bush is, but we're gonna find out. That was real interesting. Alright, cool. We have learned nothing. Could just be sexy ice. A very good question. Truly the question on the mind of all of us. Alright. Let's plop this launch fuel into the ship. That's not what I meant to do. Okay. Launch fuel goes there. What do I need for the pulse engine? I need tritium or pyrite. Do I have tritium? I feel like I have tritium. And then antimatter is just for the warp drive, so that's totally fine. Lemium, pure ferrite, and uranium used extensively in starship freighter construction. Total value, 125,000 units. Okay, if nothing else, I've got a crap ton of stuff that I can sell for a buttload of, like, value thus far. Can I just, like, yeah, we're just gonna put that there. So, because I can just have a bunch of stacks of that. How about I refine some carbon into condensed carbon so that I can free up some space in my inventory? then we will pick up everything. Oh, wait, nope, that's not what I meant to do. I meant to do the opposite. Sorry, let me just take that, put that there, and take that, put that there, and I thought I had regular old carbon. And there we go. Do I have anything else that I can... So I can get rid of this, because this is just dirt. Herox, I don't... Neutral alloy that uses range from pharmacology all the way to the heavy industry, chlorine and ammonia. Forms the backbone of galactic alloy trading. Okay, interesting. Life support, I do need to recharge that. Cool. And then all of this stuff is just sodium nitrate, pyrite. Cool. All of this stuff is just pretty fundamental stuff. Personal force field. I'm wondering if I want to... On activation, this module draws power from existent life to overload the multi-tool, distorting the electromagnetic field, creating a powerful personal shield. Okay, so that'd be good for combat, but I'm more in exploration mode right now, so I think I'm going to dismantle that, and we're going to see whether or not... Do I have the stuff to... No, I need another wiring loom. All right, cool. So... The nice thing is it's actually pretty easy to just change my mind and put that in. Cool. Awesome. Let me just grab that condensed carbon. Gonna put that right there. Going to pick this up. Nope. Pick it up. There we go. And this is largely useless now, so I'm just gonna leave that behind. Alright. But the save beacon, or the signal booster, is... Oh, no, that's the wrong one. Yeah, that's fine. Let me just leave. Let me just leave. Thank you. That's what I thought. Okay. What can I toss out of here? Let me recharge my multi-tool. And yeah, there's only... I can pick up tons of carbon wherever I go, so that's fine. Perfect. All right, cool. So the distress beacon is there, and we're gonna tag that, and all right. Where is it? God damn it, for real? Alright, 20 minutes? Alright, let's get out of planetary range and see if that helps with it at all. What does my time look like? Yeah, now it's 2 minutes. Alright. And normally I could pulse jump, but I'm too close to the planet right now. And I don't necessarily know why it, like, drastically reduces the time if I get farther away from the planet, because you would think that it would be, like, a greater distance, just thinking of, like, the size of the arc that you would need to make. But maybe it's the lack of drag from the atmosphere. I don't really know. 'Cause, yeah, it looks like I'm still kind of in the... I think it's the stratosphere that's the most distant from the actual planet itself. Well, it's... Oh no, this, like, halo around the planet that's all purpley actually goes a fair distance out. That's really interesting. So yeah, how's everyone doing in chat? Let me check in on you right now while we're... en route to our destination. Y'all having fun? Y'all having a good time? Lurkers lurking, I hope that you are having a lovely evening. And I hope that if you are indeed having a fun time, and if you are here for the first time, that we will maybe see you again sometime. Maybe drop a follow, tell your friends, drop a subscription if you are indeed feeling generous. And all of that sort of stuff is very appreciated. Alright. Got T-minus 30 seconds. We're back up to a minute. Okay, yep. Atmosphere is a drag. Didn't mean to make a pun there, but here we are. Come on. Give me, like, 10 seconds. Just give me, yeah, give me, like, 10. Nope, don't make the time go back up. Let me just, like, direct blast that shit from the atmosphere. There we go. Just straight down. There we go. Oh, hello there, Orion. I hope that you are having a lovely evening. Initiate landing. Bullshit. Well, I'm gonna be in next to the planet in 2 seconds, so there we go. Oh, nope, that's not what I wanted. I wanted the landing sequence. Land, land. Land, land. Awesome. Okay. Internal rain. Okay. So, what are we looking at here? Okay. So we got damaged machinery. We got distress signal. We got drop pod, distress beacon. Boundary separation failure likely. Vessel 16 emptied. Cause sentinel intervention. Of course it's sentinel intervention. Fresh iteration generated. Anomaly containment prepared. Broadcast, sure. Anomaly is compliant, position logged, system integrity scan initialized. Cool. Did I get anything from that? Nope. All right, cool, 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 cool. Love it, love to see it. My inventory is full, isn't it? Nope. Cool. I should actually slap down my usual machinery. I shouldn't, like, go about everything, especially since it takes up room in my inventory. Horrible, but I have my crew, so it ain't all bad. Well, I'm sorry to hear that you're having a rough time there, Orion. It's definitely one of those things where sometimes you can't really... It sucks because, like, you know, you want to feel better, and your friends want you to feel better and everything, but I know that sometimes that's not how it works. And sometimes you just gotta ride her out, and I hope that we are able to make that ride a little bit easier and go by a little bit quicker. And you always have a place here to hang out, and yeah, I hope that the tough times for you pass soon, my friend. Let's see, what else do we got that I want to drop here? Portable refiner, yep. Put that right there. I think that's all my baseline machinery that I need to drop. Tritium cold vault, that's fine. I might actually... Let's refine some cobalt. How much does it actually get me from that?
Technology recharging.
13. Okay, so not a whole ton. But at least I can, like, have that in there, and it'll probably take up less room. Sure, let me just drop that in the exosuit. Just drop that in the exosuit. Okay. Is this gonna get me any more info? Because it said that it was planet-wide before. How about nearby structures? It's funny that it describes a planetary sweep as finding nearby structures, but I mean, I suppose we're talking about on the scale of astronomical units here. There's another distress signal. Just no one is having a good time here. Okay. All right, let's see what's going on here. Damaged container. microprocessor, those are very useful. What's that sound? I don't like that sound. I hope that's just ambiance. It's very ominous ambiance. Let's see here. With the Patreon, I hope that the adultings are not a drag. Yeah, I hope as well. I think that everyone's really feeling it this week, for sure. Get rid of this residual goop. Get out of here. More nanites, okay. And any of these are things that I have already looted. Well, this isn't. More ammo, okay. That's not ominous at all. All right, cool. So I've got my processor there. Let's, are these vortex cubes? Okay, that's interesting. And just on the surface then, okay. That's usually very, that's very unusual. Because I can sell these and they're worth a fair bit, but I normally have to work for them. Is any of this stuff that I can scan? Also, I just gotta say, I almost want to build a base here just because this planet looks pretty sweet. Like, look at this! Look at this all this metallic, domey shit. That's super cool. Alright. So, let's take a look around here. Because we have subterranean relics, which means that we potentially have other such sorts of, like, either, like, ruins or crashed ships or knowledge stones. Let's see. Oh, what? That's some big old crystals right over here. We got another wreck. There's just my ship in my crash zone. Sweet route, distress beacon, 16 hours away. It keeps giving me these question marks for hex plate bushes, but I don't know why or like what significance they hold. And all of these are scanned already. Because yeah, normally it would be giving me like destinations out the wazoo, but it is not. I think some people just had some bad luck with the sentinels in the upper atmosphere of this planet and got proper fucked and just crashed down here. Because, yeah, it doesn't really seem like, other than the actual distress beacon, that there's anything really down here. This planet looks like someone let Brainiac loose in Minecraft. Incredibly specific, but accurate. Also, hello, Eldritch Crow, and I hope that you are having a lovely evening, and thank you for joining us. Okay, so I think what we're going to do is we're going to just start chasing down distress signals, I guess, because that seems to be the primary export of this planet. Primary export of this planet is distress. Generally not a good thing. Yeah, these little guys are fine, apparently. Yeah, let me just save that real quick. Do I have 3 spots in my inventory? I don't. Okay. Let's see. I don't even have spots in my freaking spaceship. Okay. Let me see if I can condense some of this shit. I don't need 2 units of cobalt. I can get rid of that. Unstable gel, dihydrogen jelly, ion battery. Is there any of my stuff that I can charge right now? All of it seems pretty well charged. God, I need a bigger inventory. Condensed, ionized cobalt, oxygen, copper, pyrite, sodium nitrate, hot ice. That's still funny to me. I'm never gonna get over that. And then just Herox. I need to sell a bunch of this is honestly what I need to do. And then just 2 units of geodesite is 300,000 units of cash. That's wild. Let's see. Just earth and a neon camo. Yeah, yeah, that seems about right. Yeah. Let's see here. Yeah, I've only got one spot left in there. Okay. Yeah, there really isn't anything that I can kind of condense down to less stuff. Chromatic metal is from copper, so I could condense that down a bit. Let's just see, where's my copper? Because chromatic metal also has the benefit of being able to help make warp cell fuel. So where's my quartzoro, cadmium, sodium, gold, silver, iridesite, sodium nitrate, iodized cobalt, I had copper. Where is it? There it is. And then a blam. Okay. So is there anything in my ship that needs refueling? There is the launch thruster. Yeah, I have a bunch of stuff that I just need to find a buyer for. Chromatic metal generated by fusion in the heart of a star. Such stellar metal ends up forming deposits on the crust of local planets. Chromatic metal for the use of manufactured advanced technology. Okay, cool. So this is more stuff that I can turn into chromatic metal. So we can definitely help speed that up a little bit, because this is almost done. Boom. Love to see it. And where's macadamium? There's macadamium. If there was one thing on a strictly gameplay level that I would maybe suggest to the devs is that the inventory management takes up a lot of calories, takes up a large portion of at least the first few hours of gameplay time. There are a lot of things that the game is actually quite good at kind of what is this? Buried technology module. One moment. I may need to loot. Looting commencing. Salvage data. Okay. Simple enough. More shit under here that I'm not seeing? Nope. Nope, that was it. That was just it. Okay, cool. Let me get rid of this silicate powder. Shit's always taking up my inventory. And salvage data, yeah. Unstable. Got my starship that has all of that. Okay. Magnetized pyrite. Yeah, I want to make more of that in case I need to repair more loot boxes. I mean cargo crates, so that they can, you know, try and irradiate the shit out of me, but I'll be able to open them. Boop, 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 boop. Where are you? No, that's magnetized ferrite. Okay. Very different, I guess. And it goes back down to ferrite dust. Interesting. Okay. No, come on, pick it up. You suck. Also, why Is it because there's carbon in the actual fuel tank? Can I just like put it into something else? I thought I had more condensed carbon. Because, yeah, if I try and pick it up, but there's an open spot in my inventory. So what the fuck? Let's just pop something else over there. Salvage data, because I can't use that right now. Let's just go there. Come on, pick it up. But it's carbon and not. Okay, cool, whatever. And then this is just the signal booster. Okay. Is there anything that I could dismantle that I would not miss? Is my next question. Temperature regulator and nitrogen salt. That's almost 1 million units. Holy crap. Okay, yeah. This is just. I'm a miner, and just all of my stuff is just crystals. Just big in the crystal market. Get rid of this. I don't have anything to use ionized cobalt for right now. Come on, no. I pressed the wrong button again. No. Yeah, let's just pick it up. Cool. Okay, so we got my save point. Where's the distress beacon? Cool. I feel like. Let's check out where the distress beacon is. I'm probably not going to be able to loot a whole lot of stuff that's over there, but maybe I'll get a knowledge stone or something. And then, other than that, we need to head out to the space station because I need to unload some of this stuff. Stop mining Bitcoin and start to switch back your focus to those pretty crystals. Yep, the crystal market's up. Everyone, buy big crystal. Okay, I really don't want to spend 4 minutes. I'll come back here afterwards. Let me just go quick to commerce. Yeah, no, my pulse engine has tons of freaking fuel, so I'm good for that for a while. Do. Coming in for a landing. I wonder what polygon this space station will be shaped like. It looks like a combination of them. Looks like Weebly from, or whatever the hell his name is, from Portal 2. Let's see. Do. All right. All right, friends. Show me who wants to buy my various moon rocks. Quiet up here. Okay. Okay, so we're getting closer to being able to understand stuff. Do you want any of my stuff? No? Okay, so what I want mainly is the improved multi-tool. So you're all tech, so you're probably not going to want to buy my stuff either. Yeah, okay, that's fine. There's a lot of you here though. Exocraft upgrades. Okay, I don't have exocraft yet, I don't think. Or is an exocraft just a spaceship? That's been made kind of unclear. Let me just get an extra inventory slot, please. Because those things are worth their weight in gold. Two upgrade modules. Let's see what you have. Yeah, life support module, radiation protection module. Might want to invest in that. Let me look at that sentence. I want to translate it. Sure. Here, let's go back to the multi-tool merchant. Where are you? First and foremost, let me get a look at this multi-tool. It's smaller, so that tells me it's probably not going to be... Yeah, let's go... Slightly larger inventory. It's much cheaper than the other one, but I mean, I might be able. We'll see. We'll see. Silent stasis obstructor. Okay, interesting. All right, let's take a look at this person's sentence. I'm guessing that Anja is probably hello or a greeting. We could say welcome to. Something, hello friend, welcome to something Gex something, something traders something something. Interesting. So there aren't any repeating words, so it doesn't make it super easy. But there's a couple of things there. What do you got for us, Sin? What do you think? Because yeah, without the first couple of ones are a greeting, pretty simply. Which there's only a few kind of different, at least generic options, given that the game is still using English and kind of phonetic structure or grammatical structure. But the other ones, I'm not entirely sure. It isn't one-to-one in terms of lettering. Okay. I think the words are just, I think it's just randomly generated. But yeah, here, I'm going to... Is it all right if I leave? Because I'm going to go around and I'm going to see if someone wants to buy my moon rocks. Will you buy my moon rocks? Yep, purchase old scrap. Or rather, sell old scrap. Let's see. Why is well, I mean, the demand is up. Sure. Unstable gel, Herox, silver. Vortex cubes. Hot ice. And then I think that's all, because I have unstable gel. And then I don't have anything for Herox right now that I can use it for, so I might as well use it for commerce. The hydrogen jelly, ion battery, magnetized ferrite, and yeah, this is all just my generic sort of stuff. Okay, cool. So that clears out a little bit of room. What do I have for nanites? Yeah, that would be a million of that. I feel like what I want to do is, because I got a shiny new inventory slot here, so that gives me a little bit more flexibility. The other multi-tool in the other galaxy was 5 million credits. I don't know if, because I mean, this one is less than, like, almost 10% of what the other one is, but I want to get something beyond what I currently have, because this is not super doable. So, you know, what can I buy this? Buy and add to collection. Why don't I, yeah, let's trade in the current one. So, I still have, yeah, that still gives me plenty of flexibility. So why don't I because we have the terrain manipulator. Okay, so I need to make some. Yeah, carbon nanotubes, that's totally fine. Let me. Cool. And carbon nanotubes. I need another. Yep, alright, cool. Can I. I don't have enough carbon. I don't have enough carbon. That's cool. That works. Can I just... No, I can't plop down my stuff in the middle of the lobby, can I? Alright. Alright. Can I just purchase some? Sir, may I please see your finest carbon nanotubes, please? Let's see. The words also change depending on whether they're at the beginning of the sentence or capitalized. Okay, interesting. Like, they don't just change as in their proper nouns or their, like, just regular nouns. Like, the words themselves actually change. That's really interesting. Capitalist, come on now. I am just barely trying to survive. My ship is still a piece of tin. Tycoon, this is not cool. This is not cool. I don't appreciate it. I had a near space loan of 1,000,000 credits. Alright, so cartographer. Yeah, envoy. Yeah, you probably don't even want to talk to me, do you? Maybe friend? Okay. Explorers Guild, they do not seem interested in the data that I offer. Perhaps the mission listings agent on the station might have a way to prove my worth. Okay. So this seems like a faction thing. Which is valid. Enormous metal cog. I appreciate the specificity of the actual size of it. Let's see. So life support gel, solar mirror, dihydrogen gel. Can I buy carbon? Would you kindly give me some carbon? The answer appears to be no. Pugnium, essential properties with nanites, carbon, solar mirror, oxygen. At that kind of price, how could I lose? You don't just have cogs come at that sort of discount all the time. Alright. So, I don't need that. How about... Hey, Dag, what's up? Yarthnek, yours, Elspar. Okay, cool. Let's learn some new words. From side to side as they consider me. Friendship, trade, and travel. We're going to go friendship. The Gek word for please. They have a word for please. Okay, interesting. This is making me think of the movie Arrival, which I am a super, super big fan of. Because, like, you start parsing language and you realize how much of what we consider of it is based off of assumptions from our own language, which is kind of based on how you perceive things as a person. But then as you start looking at other languages and other people and their experiences, it can rapidly, like, violate those assumptions. So let's see, practice language skills. What's up? How about help? Shakes the... I may have mispronounced my request. Oh no. Okay, well, I didn't make them angry because my standing with the Gek would have gone down. So that is good to know. Oh, come on, buddy. I don't have an agricultural terminal yet. I promise that I will hire you when I have one. But I do not, and so we cannot do business. Encrypted navigation data? More encrypted. Someone just kind of left these. I mean, I'm not gonna say no to some free encrypted navigation data. That's interesting. That's so cool. Yeah, no, there's some really interesting choices in this game. I do like the emphasis on communication. Like, I spent the first several hours just kind of going around the planet looking for knowledge stones because I wanted to learn more Gek words so that I could speak with them. So yeah, that's super interesting. But yeah, I think on that note, since we're coming up on 3 hours, I believe that we are going to call the stream for the evening for tonight. Let me pop over to IRL here to say salutations and good evenings to people for the last time this evening. Once again, if you were coming through the stream for the first time, I am Dichotomous Prime, aka Vince. We do the same kinds of fun stuff, usually Monday and Friday evenings, 5:30 to 8:30. I've been trying to do the Wednesday thing recently, and energy's been holding up, so hopefully that continues. But usually you'll catch me Mondays and Fridays talking about game design stuff, talking about social justice related stuff, decolonization sort of related things, and all kinds of interesting gamey, designy, philosophic-y choices. So if you did enjoy the if you did enjoy the stream, please bring your friends, spread the word. Word of mouth is always a huge help, especially for the small timers like myself. Let's see who's up to some cool stuff this evening, for me to send y'all over to say hi. A doop a doop doop doop. Oh, Lady Confetti is doing some cool stuff. So I think that is what we will do for the evening. Milady Confetti, and she is always cool, always a badass. So we will send y'all over to go say hi to her and bring the good tidings. So everyone, thank you for coming by and hanging out. I hope you had a lovely time. Please take care of yourselves, and we will see y'all on Friday. Have a good evening, everybody.